Does this image look familiar? You may know it as an album cover for the famous post-punk band The Strokes, but I've got a surprise for you. It's really a picture of charged subatomic particles inside a giant bubble chamber. Yeah, you heard me right. This artistic, iconic image was generated by one of the many interesting ways we've tried to see the subatomic particles in our world, which is harder than it sounds because subatomic particles can be tricky. Take neutrinos, for example. They're a fundamental particle of the universe, and they are quite literally everywhere around us all the time. You have neutrinos passing through you right now. But the catch is that they have no charge and minuscule mass. Some even say no mass at all. And this means that they interact so little with the matter around them, we don't notice them zinging through the Earth and our bodies at nearly the speed of light all day long. And that's also what makes them so hard to find, measure, and understand. How do you look at a thing that doesn't interact with anything? Very creatively is the answer. Which brings us back to the album cover. Like I mentioned, this dreamy image was generated by the equally dreamy sounding bubble chamber. The Gargamel, for example, was a bubble chamber used at CERN in the 70s, consisting of a muon neutrino beam and nearly 12 cubic meters of heavy liquid freon. Using Gargamel, researchers could observe the charged particles set in motion by the neutrinos, kind of like seeing the shadow of the neutrino. This is the reason the neutrino is sometimes referred to as the ghost particle. You can't see the neutrino itself, but you can see them knocking stuff around if you arrange things properly. Not only did this instrument help us see neutrinos, but also provided crucial early evidence that quarks exist. And even though it was short-lived due to some cracks in its structure, this particular bubble chamber played a really important role on the road to our current understanding of particle physics. Since then, we've moved on to some more sophisticated methods of neutrino detection, which you can learn about here. But what about some more of the ones that just look cool? Like liquid argon time projections. Remember how Gargamel used heavy liquid freon? Well, after that, we moved on to argon, which can be kept in its liquid phase more easily than the rest of the noble gases. In a liquid argon time projection chamber, or TPC, one charged particle produces 55,000 electrons with every centimeter it travels. The way the electric and magnetic fields in a TPC are set up allows the electrons to travel uniformly through the argon, and there are tons of them. Both of these things mean that TPCs give really clean, crisp, high-resolution details of neutrino interactions, and they're able to capture a lot of them simultaneously. And last but not least, my favorite, Cherenkov radiation, which just looks like something out of a movie, honestly. Nothing travels faster than the speed of light, right? Well, that's only true in a vacuum, like space. Here on Earth, light actually travels a bit slower than its peak speed through transparent media like water, for example, when other subatomic particles, like electrons given off as radiation from a nuclear reactor, travel through water faster than light does, it produces this radically cool blue glow. Some of the neutrino observatories we use today incorporate what we call water Cherenkov detectors. Like the Sudbury Neutrino Observatory, a neutrino detection facility that happens to also be the deepest cleanroom in the world, at 2 kilometers below the Earth's surface. In this detector, a neutrino passing through a special water tank sets a muon or an electron in motion, producing Cherenkov radiation. Scientists can see and reconstruct the moment that light begins, therefore essentially seeing the moment the neutrino hit that muon or electron. Sometimes science imitates art, I guess. Which one is your favorite? Love science pictures? Make a website and eternalize your favorites with domain.com. Domain.com is awesome, affordable, reliable, and has all the tools you need to build a new website. They can fulfill all your website needs. They offer .com and .net domain names and intuitive website builders. They have over 300 domain extensions to fit your needs, from .club to .space to .pizza. Take that first step in creating an identity online and visit domain.com. Fun fact, that Strokes album is called Is This It?, which kind of melds perfectly with the whole concept behind the cover. I can picture the scientists standing around, looking at each other, asking themselves, is this it? Is this a neutrino? To keep up with all the developments on the quantum level, subscribe to Seeker and check out this video on quantum computing. Thanks for watching.